simple things to represent the term anxiety. Imagine you are not ready for a test at school, you hear the teacher calling your name, and you feel a tight squeeze in your stomach. Who has never been afraid of failure? If I thought of making it concrete, I would imagine a steaming grey cloud, constantly changing, capable of arising in every corner. But what is it really, a feeling or an emotion? We always talk about anxiety in two contrasting ways, overestimating and underestimating it. The state of alert that we experience can have a double effect on our body. It can make us more reactive and faster in finding a solution. On the other hand, if the state of stress persists, it can cause health problems of different magnitude. The current context we are facing forces us to live in a condition of continuous uncertainty and concerning. This new reality, born from the coronavirus emergency, has led to a radical change in daily lifestyle. The impossibility of action that apparently were trivial allows us to appreciate small moments. We all need a hug, one of those that fill your heart and give you security and protection. Living in a continuous sense of instability makes us even more fragile than we are, and the absence of social contact does nothing but increase this type of sensation. It is precisely in moments like these that we become aware of our inner self, of past and future choices. The philosopher Friedrich Nietzsche said, "Sit as little as possible, do not trust thoughts that were not born in the open air and on the move, which are also not a feast for the muscles." Now more than ever, on the basis of these words, I wonder how far I can trust my thoughts in self-isolation. It says if I repeated the same word until I no longer understood its meaning. And more elaborate than what we usually do. We see ourselves as suspended in a thread in the sky between the life we knew and the life that will return. We are unaware of our fate, and, walking with attention and audacity, we realize the weight of our steps. We, therefore, need a strong balance, a constant search for our life. But the most common feeling is a great sense of helplessness. It is as we have a goal, and as we get closer, the finish line seems to move away. Quarantine is a strange lens through which everything in the world can be observed. We focus and reflect on thoughts that were not even considered before. But this new way of looking at things has finally created a sense of community. In a world of frenzy where little general cohesion prevails, we rarely use the term we. For the first time, it takes on value. People unite to save lives and change the world, and the sum of many sacrifices will help us to overcome the situation. We have led our lives to take care of our inner self, our high. But when what is around begins to collapse, we feel small and vulnerable. We understand that we share the same fragility and our lives could make sense wholly together. A common goal is necessary to move towards the same wavelength. Life on a nervous planet, I found myself experiencing some of the anxieties of the contemporary world. The stimulating, curious and creative part of the book consists of inventing the psychogram, unit of measurement, that is the amount of available psychological energy. The author draws up a list of reasons that remove the psychograms from his life. Let's take an example. Exams, toxic friendship or a bad mark led us to subtract the so-called psychograms. But in the same way, likewise, situation allows us to add this bizarre unit of measure. Everyone has their own psychograms. Music or dance for someone, the smell of the rain or the wind in their hair for someone else. It will be useful to remember what makes our life wonderful and make at least three of these gestures every day. So now more than ever, in a moment of total confusion, it will be beneficial not only to do it for ourselves, but also for others, for humanity. For the first time, always following a common line, understanding the problems that take away psychograms from our world, it will be nice to carry out as many. We are facing a sandstorm. When we come out, we will not be the ones who entered, because sprinkled throughout the body with small grains. The grains of sand will remain on in our body for a long time. I strongly hope and believe that the sense of community created by this situation will remain among them. Nothing is lost time, so in facing this often complicated and turbulent journey, let's elicit psychograms to make it sensational.